Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Okay? So this is one of the best personal finance books of all time. Okay? So every time meron akong kausap na investor or entrepreneur, this is the book that inspired them to take action, to pursue passive income, to pursue financial freedom. Okay? So if nabasa mo na to, okay, nabasa mo na tong book na Rich Dad, Poor Dad, so let me know in the comments below, ano ba yung pinaka the best lesson that you've learned in this book? Okay? Tapos if you haven't read this book yet, okay, so you watch this video because I'm gonna summarize, okay? I'm gonna summarize the 6 lessons here in this book, and I'm also gonna share yung personal, yung key takeaway, yung pinaka best lesson that I've learned in this book. Okay, so if that is something that you're interested with, make sure you check this video out. Hi guys, this is Stuart Pilo of freedomlovephdot.com. Tapos, wala nang intro. Let's get started, okay? Rich Dad, Poor Dad, 6 lessons here in this book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad. So, lesson number 1, okay? First lesson, the rich, okay, don't work for money, alright? So, the rich don't work for money. Instead, they let their money work for them. So, sa lesson na to, basically, dito in-introduce ni Robert na a lot of times people, they trade their time, okay, for money. So, basically, yan yung job, diba? So, yan yung job. And there's really nothing wrong with that. The only problem is that sometimes we get stuck, okay? We get stuck in a job we hate because we have bills to pay. And we really never pursue true freedom, okay? We never pursue true freedom because we're afraid, okay? And then we're greedy kasi we're expecting a raise, okay? Next year, mag-increase yung sweldo mo, okay? But then again, you fear quitting that job because wala na yung security, okay? So a lot of times, people are stuck, okay? Because they work hard for money. But the rich, okay, they don't work for money. They let money work for them, alright? Now, lesson number 2 naman is that the rich, okay, or why is it important, okay? It's important to learn financial literacy, okay? Financial literacy, or basically this is called financial education, because a lot of times when it comes to education, outdated na yung mga lessons natin from school, diba? Like, imagine you're learning for 20 years in school, tapos pag-graduate mo, hindi mo naman magagamit yung course mo, diba? So basically, very important na we learn about financial education, how to manage money. Tapos dito din in-introduce ni Robert yung concepts about assets and liabilities, okay? Tapos yung cash flow mo, okay? Yung income, expenses, how it works. In fact, I'm gonna share yan. I'm gonna share later yan yung one of the key takeaways ko, yung paano ba nag-work yung cash flow natin. And most of the time, the poor and middle class, okay? Very specific yung cash flow nila. But the rich, okay, by the time they receive their income, iba yung the way they manage it, okay? So later, check mo, how do you manage your money? Do you manage your money like the poor or middle class mindset or the people with rich mindset? And by the way, very important, poor, rich, okay, this is not a status, okay? This is the mindset, okay? So it's the mindset of and how do you think? Do you think like a rich person? Do you think like a poor person? Okay, so it's not about the money that you have right now, okay? It's about the mindset, okay? So later, I'm gonna show you yung key takeaways ko, kung paano ba, how do they, the rich and the poor, manage yung money nila. Now, the third lesson naman is minding your own business, okay? So dapat meron kang sarili mong business, because in job security, in having a job, yun, wala kang full control of your income. You're just dependent kung kailan ka, you're gonna get a raise, okay? You're dependent with the benefits, okay? So you don't have full control. So sa business naman, basically, of course, it's risky, okay? But that's the price you're paying, because once you have your own business, meron kang control of your time, you have control of your income, okay? In fact, reading this book, Rich Dad Poor Dad, a lot of people, they pursue business because of this book, okay? And yeah, it's very important na meron kang sariling business because you own your own time and you own your own income, okay? Tapos yung suggestion naman in pursuing a business is that very important na you do it on the side, okay? So let's say for example, meron kang full-time job, okay? On the side, nag-explore ka ng mga business opportunities, okay? So like personally ako, when I was still working in the corporate world as a chemical engineer, okay? On the side, meron akong side hustle, being a financial advisor, okay? Being a financial advisor, I was in the financial services, and when yung income ko doon nag-increase, then basically nag-decide ako na mag-quit sa full-time job ko and pursue yung career na yun. Tapos from financial advisor, nag-pursue din ako having my own online business, and ngayon, we also have our marketing agency. Okay, so basically, it's very important na you approach business parang cautiously, okay? So meron kang full-time job, okay? On the side, you build a business, okay? Now, bilisin natin kasi I don't wanna take long dito sa 6 lessons. So, lesson number 4, this is all about corporation, okay? Corporation and taxes, okay? So, this is personally, hindi ko pa to siya na-apply in personally, okay? Corporation and taxes, but anyway, I'll explain that later. Number 5 naman is the rich, okay? They invent, okay? They invent money, okay? So, I'll explain in a while. And number 6 naman is they don't work for money, okay? Don't work for money, okay? Work to learn, okay? Work to learn. So, sa corporation, basically, dito, magka-create ka ng corporation, okay? Kasi ganito eh, for employees, usually, they earn money, tapos, matatax sila, okay? Merong tax. And then, in fact, masyashak tayo na ang laki ng tax deductions, di ba? So, may tax deductions and then you're able to spend. However, for corporations, you earn money, tapos you spend, okay? After you spend, dun pa muna yung tax deductions, okay? So, personally, wala pa akong experience nito, but this is something that I'm also looking forward to implementing, okay? Next would be rich invent money, okay? They invent money. So, basically, this is all about learning to see opportunities. Like, isa sa mga examples niya dun is, meron sa nakita ng property, okay? Tapos, they, kahit you don't have money, okay? You're able to buy that property without having your own money. So basically, parang maghanap ka lang ng buyer, maghanap ka ng property, you meet them, okay? Tapos dun ka kikita. So you invent money without really, hindi ka naglalabas ng pera. It's basically being able to see opportunities, okay? Without requiring money. And lastly, you don't work for money, you work to learn, okay? So isa sa mga examples niya dun, dito sa book, is that he worked in a certain company, international company, because he wants to know about international trading. Tapos he worked in Xerox, okay? So basically yung photocopy machine, okay? He was a salesman doon because he wanna learn the skill of selling. Kasi sabi dito sa book is, you're just actually one skill away to living yung gusto mo na life, okay? So you're one skill away. So you learn to work, okay? You work to learn, okay? You work to learn a skill na later on, ma-apply mo na for your business, okay? So, ito yung 6 lessons in Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Now, let me share naman yung personal takeaway, yung pinaka-the biggest lesson, most impactful reading this book. Okay, so let's go! So, ito yung biggest lesson that I learned in the book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, okay? The secret to getting rich, okay? The secret to getting rich, okay? However, before I reveal that one, okay? So, if you're enjoying this video, like mo naman yung video tapos, consider subscribing, okay? So, ano ba yung secret of getting rich? It's very simple. Sabi sa book is that you need to know the difference between assets, okay? Dapat alam mo ano yung assets and alam mo ano yung liabilities, okay? So, you need to know what are assets, what are liabilities, and buy assets, okay? So, yun yung biggest takeaway ko. You just need to know ano yung difference ng assets and liabilities, and you buy assets. So, basically, assets, these are things that you buy, acquire, or you build that puts money into your pocket, while liabilities takes money out of your pocket, okay? So, ngayon, let's check, okay? Let's check how does the poor, the middle class, and the rich mindset, what do they do with their income, okay? So, paano ba minamanage nila yung money nila, okay? So, the poor mindset, okay? The poor mindset, basically, they receive income, okay? They receive income, tapos, punta na kaagad sa expenses, okay? So, they have income, tapos, punta na kaagad sa expenses. So, yun, isang kahit isang tuka, di ba? So, income, tapos, spend na kaagad. Tapos, for the middle class naman, sa middle class, and why most middle class, they struggle is because ganito yung cash flow nila. Okay, so let me erase this first. So, for the middle class naman is ganito yung nangyayari. So, they have income, okay, papasok yung income, bibili sila ng liabilities, okay? Tapos, itong liabilities, it incurs additional expenses. Okay, so, ganito yung cash flow nila. So, income, bili ng liabilities, expenses. So, liabilities, usually, ito yung mga debts, okay? Debts like, tapos like credit card debts, mortgage, okay? Tapos, car, okay? Car payments, loan payments. So, basically, that's why a lot of middle class, they really struggle financially because once meron silang income, they buy, okay? things they thought are assets but in fact are liabilities, okay? They splurge, okay? And then, of course, that will incur more debt. That's why a lot of people, they are stuck in the rat race because they work hard, they spend on liabilities, and there are more expenses, so they work hard again, and they never, hindi sila nakakaalis sa rat race because of this cash flow, okay? So ngayon naman, how does the rich, okay? How does the rich manage their money? And bakit ito yung secret in getting rich, okay? The rich naman, ganito yung how they handle their money. Okay, so meron silang income, and they, part of their income, okay, they buy assets. Tapos itong assets na to, it produces more income. Okay, it produces more income. And then, of course, maintain or low lifestyle, konti lang yung expenses, dun na yung expenses. So, basically, merong income, buy an asset, tapos yung asset would add more income and then expenses. So, parang ganun yung way of yung how they handle money. So basically, it's like the rich getting richer because they have money working, giving more money to them, okay? So basically, yan yung the secret of getting rich. Know what are assets, know what are liabilities, and buy lots of assets. And if you're wondering, ano ba yung mga assets, okay? Ano ba yung mga assets that would give us more income? So basically, these are assets na nag-generate ng passive income. Passive income. And if you're wondering ano itong mga different passive income, so I have a recent video, okay? Meron akong video, you can check top right of this video, okay? Yung top 5 passive income ideas ko for this year. So you might also want to check that video out. Okay, so that is it. That is the summary on Rich Dad Poor Dad book. Tapos yung biggest key takeaway ko in the book. Okay, so let me know. Ikaw, ano ba yung biggest takeaway mo in terms of the book Rich Dad Poor Dad? Okay, tapos in this video, ano ba yung mga aha moments mo? Let me know in the comments below because I read each and every of your comment. Okay. And that is it. Okay, so if you find this video valuable, make sure you hit that subscribe button and ping that notification bell and hit mo naman yung like video for the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to start your passive income journey with me, visit my website freedomlovephd.com. Again, that's freedomlovephd.com, and hope to see you inside. Okay, so once again, this is Theo Pillow, and create your desired lifestyle. Bye-bye!